Welcome back, everybody. Derek Sue, your East Oakland advocate. Well, are you a big coffee drinker? I know I sure was. I've just recently switched away from coffee, and I'll tell you why. It's for the health benefits of green and herbal teas. For years, I've been an avid coffee drinker. I had my own favorite brands. I had my favorite dark roast coffee, and then I put in just a little bit of half and half, or I drink it black. And so for years that went on, for decades, and it was just at the turn of the year. My doctors made some recommendations for my diet, and I'm at a point now, I'm 63. My metabolism has changed drastically from my younger days. And so I had to make some changes. I had to cut out a lot of salt. I had to take away, I can't even buy sugar now. I have to use sugar substitutes. And so I'm using Splenda as my sugar substitute. I used to use the pink stuff, but not anymore. Splenda is more natural sweetener than Splenda, or as Splenda, rather than that pink stuff. So my biggest change, and I thought I'd have a harder time than I did, but I didn't have that big of a deal changing over to tea. And my doctors recommended, because I have high blood pressure, I have type 2 for a while. I had type 2 diabetes, and I'm still on medication for that, which is metformin. And so the doctor recommended that, because he asked me, are you a big coffee drinker? I said, yeah, absolutely. I probably drink at least half a gallon a day. And he's like, whoa, that's way too much. And so he said, do you realize what coffee does to your system? And so he explained it to me, and it was an eye opener. And so I switched over at the beginning of the year to green teas and herbal teas. And so one, I was looking up, the benefits of green teas and herbal teas, and here's what I found. Number one, green teas and herbal teas are loaded with antioxidants, which are good for your body and help slow down the aging process of your body. It also helps support brain functions. And so, I'm getting older, and so things are a little fuzzier, and this does help. I have found myself to be sharper than I was, and so it is helping with the brain functions. Also, it helps with your metabolism to have fat loss. The tea helps your metabolism speed up by excuse me, by helping with your metabolism and getting rid of fat. And I have certainly noticed that since the top of the year, because one of the things that really scared me, my doctor said, well, you're at 215, we have a goal of 185, so you're a long ways, and you actually went the wrong way since our last checkup. So easy choice. And let me tell you, I have lost a significant amount of weight since the top of the year to right now, and we're talking 3 months now. It's January, February, and then now we're second week of March, and I'm feeling a whole lot better. And I'll tell you what, during the holidays, my belt was two notches, second notch from being maxed out in length. Now I am all the way down to the very, very first notch. That is significant. I haven't been there in years. And so it feels good. And I feel a lot better. I'm not in a haze, and so COVID did cause a little bit of haziness for a while, but now with the herbal teas and green teas, it has helped. And then during the influenza that I was experiencing and the RSV, I was drinking peppermint tea. And so that helped open up the nasal passages, and I could smell the peppermint. So that tells me, you know, that things are working. And then when I had COVID and I couldn't smell it, I knew I had COVID. So herbal teas don't have caffeine for the most part. And I feel a whole lot better. I remove caffeine from my diet, my daily intake. Even if I grab a soda off the shelf at the store, I make sure it is sugar-free. And also, I look for certain sugar substitutes. I try and not have corn fructose sweeteners in my drinks, or I'll drink a natural type of lemonade, tea, again, tea. So teas have a lot of benefits. And coming from an Asian culture, I grew up with that. And we had a host of different types of teas, not just the standard oolong, like a lot of people know, but also chrysanthemum and jasmine tea. I mean, it was endless. I couldn't believe all the different types of teas. But I'm getting back to tea, and not so much anymore with coffee. And so anyway, it also helps reduce the chance of developing heart disease. And so that could lead to strokes. And so that's something that I have to look at. And also the green tea and herbal teas have a cleansing effect on your arteries. And so right now I'm hoping that any damage that I did because of so much coffee drinking and bad eating habits, that this is starting to help repair those things and clear those arteries of the cholesterol that builds up inside. But I do feel better. I feel a lot better now. My blood pressure is totally under control. And so some of the other benefits, green teas and herbal teas are rich in polyphenols, and that helps reduce inflammation throughout your body and also to help fight against cancers. That's the antioxidants at work that are present in green teas and herbal teas. One of the other benefits that I came across, it can possibly reduce your risk for ladies' breast cancer, and it can lower it by 20 to 30%. So get off the coffee, get on green and herbal teas. My second wife, she was a big herbal tea drinker, but she also drank coffee too. But anyway, ladies, get on herbal teas, green tea, to help reduce that chance of breast cancer. Because I was just watching show talking about the increased breast cancer risk for those with very fibrous breasts. And so it's a little bit trickier to detect those cancer cells. Another cancer is prostate cancer. So you men, this can help reduce your prostate cancer risk. And then my favorite, and the one that, you know, I contracted, was colorectal cancer. And so this green tea and herbal tea, if I had started taking it earlier, I could have possibly lowered my risk for the colorectal cancer. But because I was probably such a high coffee drinker, that's why I got colorectal cancer so young. because typically in my family, the men never contracted colorectal cancer before 70. And I was 55 when I contracted. So that is a significant difference. So drink green teas, herbal teas. Also, one of the side benefits, quietly, that nobody really noticed, is that it helps control bad breath. So if you're a herbal tea drinker, green tea drinker, you're not likely to offend people with your breath. So that's a benefit too. Some other facts that I found, lowers diabetes risk by 42% for type 2 diabetes, which I was. And so right now my A1C number is significantly different from where I was. I'm down to 61 now, which is a very good number, whereas a year, not even a year ago, I was at 71 A1C. So that placed me right there at type 2 diabetes, and that's what put me on metformin. And then let's see, oh, in case studies done with over 286,701 individuals, the case study found 18% lower risk of diabetes. So that's a significant number, and that's a lot of people for a study. And then it also may help prevent cardiovascular disease, which reduces your risk of strokes and heart attacks. So and it improves your LDL, which is your bad cholesterol. You don't want high numbers on that. It lowers your risk of cardiovascular disease up to 31%. So these are significant numbers and significant reasons to switch over from coffee to teas like green tea and herbal teas. And so I just wanted to let you folks know that's what I'm doing right now. I'm feeling a whole lot better since switching over to teas and getting off coffee. Also, that takes out that the problem that I have recently developed, which is lactose intolerance. And so even though I love having my half and half in my coffee, it was painful at times. So I'm glad I'm off coffee. I'm on green tea and herbal tea, and I hope you find some benefits yourself. Thanks for joining me today. We'll be right back.